department of mathematics, Ketejum College, Nasik. So today our guest is Ms. Dipali Kakriz ma'am from Ketejum College, Nasik. She is MSc mathematics from Pune University and SET qualified also. She has 10 years of experience in teaching field. So here today our topic is some applications in Python. So in session first, we see linear algebra in Python. So I request to Kakriz ma'am to start the session. Kakriz ma'am?
Yes ma'am, sure. Thank you. Hello, is the screen visible to all?
Yes ma'am. Yes ma'am.
Okay. Yesterday, Shweta ma'am has taken some part of linear algebra. Today's topic is linear algebra in Python. We are going to see the some more commands in for linear algebra in by using the Python. Yesterday, she has explained about the packages. One of them is NumPy and SciPy. So we directly use that package and go forward. In linear algebra, we are dealing with vectors and matrices mostly. So first we see how to input the vectors. Already she has explained vectors in yesterday's lecture, but still we revise some concepts. Vectors, to input vectors or matrices, we use the package import numpy as np, and second one is linear algebra, that is import scipy.linalg. If we have the vector in 3D, then we input that as some, suppose it has notation u, it is inputted by using the command np.array. np.array, in round bracket, we write the matrix. But here we are using the vector, it is in 3D vector, so we are given the input in the square bracket. The vector is in 3D, so there are three coordinates, 1, 2, and 3. Therefore, the vector, if you want to print this vector, you should write either print u or you just write u. Okay? This is the vector in 3D. If we want to determine its shape, then the command is u.shape. Because we have named the vector u, we must have to use here u.shape. Its shape means the matrix is of order 1/3, but its shape means it has the three elements, three components or coordinates. So it is given giving the output 3. If you want to take transpose of this vector, see this is the row vector. If we take its transpose, then we get column vector. For that, the command is u.t. Okay, it is given as array in bracket 1, 2, and 3. If you want to take the dot product, of u with itself, then the command is u dot t into dot u. Because how to take the dot product? We use u transpose into u. What is u? It is a three-dimensional vector. It transposes the column vector into the vector u. See what is the output? It is 14. It is calculated by using the dot product 1 into 1 plus 2 into 2 plus 3 into 3. It is what the 14. Okay. Next are some vector operations. If we have two vectors, suppose u and v, we can do the operations with more than two vectors. But firstly, suppose we have two vectors, u and v. U vector is a column vector, 3, 5. See how the column vector is given. It is given by the command np.array in round bracket. This first square bracket or array is the array for the whole matrix. Okay, this first square bracket represents array for the whole matrix, and second is first row of that column. See, we are giving the input u as a column vector. It is in the form of 3, 5. The column is 3, 5, but in the column vector, the first row is 3. Therefore, 3 is given in the first square bracket. The next row requires next square bracket. The next row is 5. In this way, we give the input for column vector. 3 is the first row of this column. 5 is second row of this column. Or you may consider the first component of the column vector as 3. Second component is given in second square bracket. If you want to print the another vector also, then you write print u and then print v. This should be you want to print the vector u and it is giving the output first column vector u and the second vector v, but it is not taking the notation for the u as u and v for the distinct column vectors. What we do with these column vectors, we can add these vectors. Simply type u plus v. What is u plus v? 3 minus 2 is 1. Component wise addition is there. 5 plus 6 is 11. We subtract these vectors. U minus v. It is 3 minus minus plus 2 will be 5. 5 minus 6 is minus 1. The next, we do the scalar multiplication of each to each vector. Suppose we write 3 into u. This star represents the multiplication. This star is used to make the multiplication of the vector by a scalar. This is what 3u. We are multiplying every element of the first column vector by 3. It is giving the output first, as a column vector, 9, 15, because we are multiplying scalar by a column, the dimension is not yet changed. Then we find the inner product of UV. For that, we require the row vectors. Suppose one vector is denoted by A. It is in 3D, suppose. And the other vector is B. It is of the same dimension. Then we take the inner product of the vectors A and B. Here, np dot inner is the command to find the inner product of two vectors A and B. Because we have given the name two vectors as AB, here we have to change the notations also. Np dot inner product AB, it gives the inner product as usual. It is taking the multiplication and then addition component wise. 1 into 3 plus 2 into 6 plus 3 into 9. This is got the inner product of two vectors. By using inner product, we can find the angle between two vectors, right? But there are some to find the angle. What is the angle between two vectors? If u and v are two vectors in Rn, suppose in n dimensional vectors, then angle theta between the two vectors u and v is given by u bar dot v bar upon norm v u bar into norm v bar, right? Cosine of the angle between two vectors is u bar dot v bar upon norm u into norm v bar. What is u bar dot v bar? That is the dot product of vectors u and v. And we require norm of that vectors also. First, we see how to find the norm of the vectors. If given the vector, okay, 0, 3, 4 is the vector u1. Then to find this norm of this vector, because it is in 3D, we write this as order is equal to 3. Np dot linear dot norm. This is what the command to find the norm of this vector, which is in 3D. Okay, see what is the norm of this vector. It is what? Square root of 0 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. It is 4.4979. By this way, we can find norm of any vector. Suppose you know the norm of this vector, 1, 0, 0. Right? What is its norm? It is 1. Because it is a unit vector. Again, we have U2 and its norm is 1. Now we are going to see how to find the angle between the two vectors. Take the two vectors. Suppose one of these vector is minus 1, 0, 1. Other is 1, 0, 1. We can find its dot product very easily. What is the dot product of A and B? A dot B gives, by simple computation, we get the answer minus 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 1 into 1, right? It gives the answer 0. We know the answer A dot B is equal to 0, but see how to find it in using the by using the Python. First, you require to find the angle between these two vectors, you require two things: dot product of two vectors and norm of each vector. We are finding the norm. First vector has norm n1. Suppose n1 is np dot linear dot norm for the vector A, and it is in 3D. Therefore, we have written order of the vector A is equal to 3. This is the norm of first vector A. We should give the input for the matrix A, column or row vector A, because already we have taken A and B as a vectors previously. So, and we are finding the angle between these two new vectors. So we should give the input of that two new vectors. This is first vector, 101 is second. Next, we are finding norm of each vector. To find the first norm of first vector, we write, we denote it by n1.
Hello.
Okay.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, what is norm here?
Now, it's distance from origin. Minus 101 is the vector. Its norm is what? It is nothing but the distance from origin.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
The first vector has norm 1.2599. The second vector is B, that is 101. If you find its norm, then it is 1.2599. Then we find the dot product of A and B. There are two commands to find the dot product. We already have calculated it is 0. See, if you represent a dot product, suppose it is by D, is equal to A dot T means transpose of A dot B. It is 0. Or you can find the dot product by using other command also, np dot dot A comma B. Dot product of two vectors is calculated by using dot A comma B. It is 0. You can use any one of these. Now, what is the angle between two vectors? It is cosine inverse, right? Cos inverse of A dot B upon norm A into norm B. Here we have written arc cos means cos inverse of D. What is D? It is dot product of AB divided by norm of the two vectors A. Norm A and norm B, it is represented by N1 and N2. This is what the final answer, okay? R cos D upon N1 into N2. To give the input, R cos, we are using the trigonometric function. So we import the package NumPy. Okay. Can anybody tell us what is the reason behind this error?
There is double C, AR cos.
R cos means cos inverse, right?
Can you type AR, np dot R cos?
Double C, there is double C, single C.
Okay, we tried. No.
B represent the np dot a comma b.
Right. D represent np dot a comma b. We have calculated that value of d. Right.
I think you should type np dot r cos.
Theta is also there.
Let us try it. Yes, right. Np dot r cos of d upon n1 in value is. Its answer is 1.57079. And what we have done, we have given the two vectors, calculated their norms, dot product, and found the angle between that two vectors. All these steps can be done within the single window. See, A is this vector, B is the another vector, D is what? Dot product of two vectors. N1 is the norm of first vector, N2 is norm of other vector, and here the angle is cos inverse of A dot B upon norm A into norm B. It is what? Np dot. Same answer is here, 1.57079. Then we can also find, if we want to find only the dot product of two vectors, we simply give the input of that two vectors. Then we write the command for dot product. A transpose of A dot B or np dot A comma B. See what is the cross product of the vectors. If we have the two vectors A1 and B1, first is 0 to 0, B1 vector is 300. Then to find the cross product, we write np dot cross the name of the two vectors. It is what? 0, 0, minus 6. Next, we find the linear combination of the vectors. If we have the finite number of vectors, first is V suppose 0, 3, 2 in three dimension. Second is 4, 1, 1. Next is 0, minus 2, 0. We can multiply each vector by a scalar and we can add that multiplication like this, 3 into V minus 2 into W plus 4 into U. See what is the output? It is minus 8, minus 1, 4. What it is doing? It is taken as a multiplication of 3 by the first vector, 0 into 3 plus 3, comma this vector. If we multiply the first vector by 3, what will happen? This is the vector V. And we are doing 3 into V. This is what 0, 9, 6. Similarly, the second vector is get multiplied by minus 2. Third vector is get multiplied by 4. And we are taking their combination. It is minus 8, minus 1 and 4. Second, we may check the vectors are linearly independent or not. If we have the three-dimensional vectors and they are 3 in number, then they are linearly independent means what? If we consider the linear combination of these three vectors, compare it with 0. If we get all the coefficients that are constant as a 0, then we say that these three vectors are linearly independent. Suppose we take the combination as A into first vector plus B into second vector plus C into third vector is equal to 0, then indirectly we are solving the homogeneous system, having 3 unknowns and 3 equations. The one of the famous method of solving that system linear system is what? Inverse method, right? Ax is equal to 0 is the system here, because we are checking these vectors are linearly independent or not. What is the solution? It is Ax is equal to b has solution A inverse into b, right? If the solution is exist, if and only if the inverse of the matrix A exists. If inverse of matrix A exists, if and only if determinant of A is not equal to 0. What we have, we want to check the vectors are linearly independent or not. That's why we are taking the linear combination of these three vectors and comparing it with 0. From that, we get a system, which is homogeneous system in the form of A into X is equal to 0, where A is the matrix of coefficients, X is matrix of unknowns, and right side is 0 matrix. That is the column vector. And if we want to find the values of A, B, C, what we do? We find whether A is invertible. If A is invertible, then we multiply AX is equal to 0 by A inverse, so that we get the values of X. What is X? It is a column vector of unknown variables. If all the unknowns are 0, then we say these vectors are linearly independent. That is possible only if determinant of A is not equal to 0. So to check whether the vectors are linearly independent, we only finding the determinant of the matrix. The matrix consists of columns as a matrix consists of vectors, each vector as a row vector. In the first row of the matrix is first vector, the second row of the matrix is second vector, and last is last. The command to find the determinant of the matrix is either you use the linear algebra command or this command, D is equal to LA dot DET of A. This is what we are finding the determinant in linear algebra. So the command is used -15.99. It is nearly equal to -16. This is what the determinant of the matrix say. It is not equal to 0. So these vectors are linearly independent. Can anybody tell that if there are only two vectors in 3D, how to check that vectors are linearly independent? If we have only the two vectors in R3 suppose, and we want to check whether are they linearly independent, what we do? We cannot go to find the determinant, right? Then if you are given the two vectors in three dimension and you want to check whether are they linearly independent or not by using the Python, what you do? Okay, think on this. Let us go to the next topic, orthogonal and orthonormal vectors. You know the orthogonal and orthonormal vectors. We are dealing with the vector operations. So we take the example on this topic also. Revise this thing. Let V be a vector space with an inner product. Okay, now we consider the non-zero k vectors, namely V1, V2 up to Vk in the vector space V. This set forms an orthogonal set if they are orthogonal to each other. What is mean by orthogonal? Their inner product is 0. Inner product of Vi, Vj 0 whenever I not equal to j. In addition, the set of vector is called orthonormal set if they are orthogonal themselves, and secondly, each vector has norm 1, that is inner product of vi with vi raised to 1 upon 2 is equal to 1. Then v1, v2, vk are called orthonormal set. And the method to find the orthonormal basis from the given basis is what the Gram-Smith orthonormalization process. What is the process? If we are given the n number of basis vectors in an inner product space V, then we consider the first vector as x1, the second vector is v2. It is given by x2 minus inner product of x2 with w1 into w1. But what is w1? w1 is normalized vector. We obtain w1 by dividing v1 by its norm. w2 is the second vector, which is again normalized, obtained by normalizing the vector v2. That is what w2 is equal to v2 upon non-v2. You know very well all these things. v3 is this third vector. And we find the n number of vectors that are from this given n number of basis vector named by v1 to vn. And which is the orthonormal basis? By normalizing all these n vectors, we get the set of n vectors again, that is w1, w2 up to wn. This is what orthonormal basis for V. See, in Python, we can also find the orthonormal basis from the given basis. We take the vectors in R2. x1 is 1 minus 3, x2 is 2, 2. This is what the basis for R2. We want to find its orthonormal basis. We want to find the orthonormal basis from this basis. See, x1 is given as 1 minus 3, give the input. X1 is the vector np dot array in round bracket, because it is row vector, it is written in single square bracket 1 minus 3. Second vector is x2, that is 2, 2. These are the two vectors. We have not printed them because what we do, we find the orthonormal basis. For that, we consider the first vector v1 is equal to x1. What is x1 vector? 1 minus 3. Here is written v1 is equal to x1. Then how to find w1? w1 is the normalized vector obtained from the by normalizing the vector v1. Divide vector v1 by its norm. Then what is, and suppose the norm of v1 is n1, because v1 is the first vector, we are just denoting it by n1. n1 is norm of the vector v1, because it is two dimensional, we have written here order 2. W1 is what? W1 is V1 upon norm V1. We have denoted norm by N1. V1 upon norm V1 is nothing but 1 upon N1 into W1. Norm is a scalar. Therefore, we have written here star to take the multiplication of this vector. W1 is V1 upon norm V1. Norm V1 is a scalar. Hence, we have written 1 upon N1 star V1. That is what W1 vector. Then how to get the vector V2? V2 is X2 minus inner product of X2 with W1 into W1. Suppose that the inner product of X2 with W1 is denoted by I1, because it is the first inner product for this example only. We are denoting it by I1 is equal to np dot inner. This is what the command to find the inner product of x2 with w1. Okay, what is the formula for v2? It is x2 minus inner product of x2 with w1 into w1. Okay, inner product is given by i1. It is the scalar. Therefore, we have just written here I1 star W1. I1 star W1 is a vector. X2 is also a vector. So we get the vector D2. That is what? 2.4 and 0.8. Here, I will just check that whether are this vector linearly independent or not, because it is given as a basis. If we take the matrix A, whose rows are the vectors. First row is x1, second row for the matrix A is x2. Here, matrix A is given and its determinant is non-zero. And then I have proceeded to find the vectors v1 and v2. Now we have the two vectors v1 and v2, but what is orthonormal basis? It is the v1 upon norm v1 and v2 upon norm v2. We denote that by w1 and w2. Already we have here w1 vector and we find w2 now. What is w2? Normalize the vector v2 by dividing its norm. It is what? Norm v2 is n2. Norm v2 is denoted by n2 here. np dot linear dot norm. The norm is for v2. So we have written v2 here and it is in two dimensional space. So order is 2. w2 is what? v2 upon norm v2. Norm is n2. So it is 1 upon n2 into v2. Which is the orthonormal basis then? The orthonormal basis is w1 and w2. That is what? 2.4.8 and second vector is 0.9486 and 0.3162. In this way, we find the orthonormal basis. Then there are some matrix operations. How to input the 2x2 matrix? Suppose A is the matrix, np dot array. In round bracket, the first row is written in first square bracket, comma, second row is written in second square bracket. This is what the A matrix. Then we multiply A matrix by A matrix by using some commands. There are different commands. One of them is np dot matrix multiplication. That is matmul A comma A. We are multiplying A with A. Therefore, there is A comma A. See, the same answer is obtained in the next step. A at the rate symbol is used also to make the multiplication of matrices. Okay. A into A is obtained by using this command, or you can also find the A square by taking the power of A. How to take the power? We use double star 2. This is for the A square. A raised to 2 is not to take the matrix multiplication of A with A. It is only taking the square of each element. See, the matrix A is 1, 2, 3, 4. The first entry, the entry belongs to first row and first column is 1. Its square is 1. The second entry, 2, belonging to first row and second column, its square is 4 here. The next entry is 4 and its square is 16. Means A double star 2 gives the matrix that contains the entries which are obtained by taking the square of each entry separately. If you have this matrix, then A raised to 2 gives only the square of each entry in the matrix. If you want to display the element belongs to first row and second column, which is the element of the matrix first row and second column, it is 2. Then the command used is, see, index in Python starts from 0. 0, we generally represent the index in the first position as a row vector and second position is for column. The first position, at the first position, 0 is there. So we are considering the first row, and at second position, 1 is there. It stands for second column. First row and second column entry is 2. If you want to display it or use it, then we use this A of 0, 1. It gives the output as an entry belongs to first row and second column. What is the size of A? It is 4. Number of elements. How to get the trace? Np dot trace A. Then shape of the matrix. That is 2x2. How to get the rank of matrix? in linear algebra, we find it rank by using linear dot matrix underscore ranking. It is 2. Transpose is obtained by taking A dot T. See, rows are changed to column 1, 2, 4, 5 is the matrix A, and transpose is 1, 4, 2, 5. How to find the determinant? LA dot DET works. Also, you can use this another command. Minus 2.99, it is nearly equal to 3. NP dot linear dot determinant DET also gives the same answer. You can use any one. Then inverse. Same is for inverse. You can use LA dot INV or linear dot INV. If we want to print the identity matrix of order 3 by 3, then print NP dot EYE, or simply you write I is equal to, instead of print, you know the command, then you just give the name I is equal to NP dot EYE of 3. And print I. The matrix, not necessarily square matrix, whose entries are, all entries are 1, is given by NP dot 1s. Its order is 3 by 2. It gives the matrix having 3 rows and 2 columns, having all the entries 1. Then if you want to find the transpose of this, shape of the transpose of above matrix, then we directly, it is not necessary that to find first transpose and then take shape. We use O dot T dot shape, 2 by 3. O matrix is of order 3 by 2, so its transpose has shape 2 by 3, right? And what is O dot T? It is 2 by 3 matrix. Next, we display the matrix of any order having all the entries zeros. Yes? The zero matrix is of order 2 by 4, is obtained by using NP dot zeros in bracket 2 comma 4. The double round bracket is necessary to obtain such a matrix. Then if we want to write any matrix of any order having the constant entries, suppose the constant entry is 6. This is what, in previous steps, we have written the matrix having all the entries 1, matrix having all the entries 0. If we want matrix having all the entries another than 1 and 0, use np dot full matrix, write the order of the matrix. It is supposed 2 by 2, and the entry we want to print it to be 6. This is what, 2 by 2 matrix having all the entries as a 6. Next, we find matrix having all the entries 4, but that not necessary. The matrix is a square matrix. We have the matrix of order 2 by 3 having all the entries 4. If we want random matrix, any matrix, suppose it is of order 2 by 2, then it prints this matrix. Observe that all the entries are in between 0 to 1. Okay, the matrix of order 2 by 2 having random entries is, and the entries are being between 0 to 1. The command is np dot random dot random. But if you want to restrict these entries between some integers or numbers, then we write np dot random dot rand int 0 to 10. Suppose I want the entries in between 0 to 10, and matrix is of order 2 by 2, then it gives the entries, it gives the random matrix with entries 4 to 4 2. We change the order here, suppose 3 by 2. Yes, it is not taking the entry, it is not taking the entry of the matrix in between 10 is not there. Okay. Okay, it is taking the entries from 0 to 9. And because the index starts from 0, it will consider only 10 integer entries starting from 0 and ends at 9. You can obtain matrix of any order. Then matrix norm is there. The first one norm is given by maximum of summation I runs from 1 to n modulus of Aij. This is first norm. Matrix norm corresponding to infinity norm is maximum of summation j is equal to 1 to n. The sum varies for the index of column mod of Aij. What is the condition number? It is norm A into norm A inverse. By considering these two norms, we can find the norm. Suppose A matrix is of order 3 by 3, having entries 2 minus 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 3 minus 1, 4. And we want to find its norm. Norm of the matrix A. What is it? 5.83095. It is nearly equal to 6. See, if you find the norm, what is the definition? Norm of A is maximum of summation of mod of Aij, where I runs from 1 to n. I runs from 1 to n, vary the value of I. What is the sum of first column elements? Elements of first column, 2 plus 1 plus 3 is 6. And last column has also 1 plus 1 plus 4 is 6. The middle column, the sum of the elements of second column is minus 2, but we are taking the modulus, so it is 2. What is the maximum among these two, three sums? It is 6. It is giving the output nearly equal to 6, not exactly equal, exactly 6. Next, what is the condition number? It is norm A into norm of A inverse. The commands used to find the condition number of matrix A, we have given the input A, so we directly use the command np.linalg. For the condition number, we use COND of the matrix A. It is 17.492977. How to find the norm A inverse? Norm A, to find the norm of A inverse, we input A first, then we find A inverse and then its norm by using this norm command. And after that, we get the same answer. Condition number of the matrix A is 17.4929. Now, if we want to check whether the two vectors are linearly independent, what we do? Previously, I have asked this same question. The answer is here. If you have the two vectors.
Not.
Are they linearly independent? Okay. How to check are they linearly independent? Consider the linear combination of vector, compare it with zero. In matrix form, we write the linear system as Ax is equal to 0, right? That 0 matrix is of order 2 by 1 here. We have given the matrix A whose rows are each vector. First vector is first row, second vector is second row. Next, we have given the input of right side column matrix, that is 0 vector. Then we try to solve this, but it is not giving the output because linalg.solve a comma b is working for the square. If coefficient matrix A is a square matrix, then it will give the output because it takes the solution like x is equal to a inverse into b. Here a is not a square matrix, so this command is not working. Then what we do? What can we do?
Madam. Yes. Run above command A1B1. Above cell. Above cell is not run, I think.
Yeah.
Just run, then I think it will be run. Just run this.
Okay, let us try. Because
just check spelling, madam.
Yes,
print,
yes.
Print, brave. Okay, just run this. No problem.
It is not necessary that to run this. Simply, this is A1. Okay. What is B1? B1 is 300. Still, it is not working. See. Okay. Because we have given the separate matrix having rows as each vectors A1 and B1. B is equal to NP dot 0. This is what the right side column vector. And then this is the command to solve the system of linear equation. AX is equal to B. But A is not square matrix. So the command is not working. Okay. See here the, what is the error? Last two dimensions of the array must be square. Okay, so A need to have the, A should have two square matrix. Then we find the maximum element of the matrix. If we have this matrix, of course you should find this answer and tell me what is the answer. That is a homework for you. This is the matrix A, 2, 5, 7. The second row is 3, 6, 4. If you want to display its maximum entry of this matrix, then what we do? NP dot max A. 7 is the maximum entry of this matrix. Then to find the minimum entry of the matrix A, you want minimum. It is 2. Suppose we want to display second column of this matrix. The second column is 5, 6. Because index is starting from 0, the first column is considered as 0, second is 1, and next is 2. Because we want the second column, we write colon in the place of row. The first place is for row and second place inside the square bracket is for column to represent the index for the column. We want second column. So we have written colon in the first place, comma, column number. Because index starts from 0, here 1 is given. NP dot maximum. Okay, it is giving the output, the first maximum element of first column. If I want to display only the first, second column, what should we do? If we want to display the second column only for this matrix, what will be the command? Guess from this command. If we want to display the second column of this matrix, A, what will be the command? A, we want second column. C, second column is indexed by 1. This is what the second column, 5, 6. Suppose we want to display the first row. What we do? A in square bracket, the position of row is what? First. But index starts from 0, hence we write 0, comma. We want only the first row, not the column. So we give the colon in the place of column. It is 257. The first row is 257. Then we will get the maximum element of either row or column. From second column, the maximum element is 6. Similarly, you can find the minimum element of, suppose you want to find the minimum element of first row, then you write np dot min of the matrix A. For the first row, we are finding the minimum element, so we have given 0 comma. In the place of column, we have written colon. It is 2. Minimum element of first row is 2. If we want to add some constant to each entry of this matrix, suppose that is 10. That is, then we do A plus 20, 20 or 10. We can add any constant number to every entry of the matrix. A matrix is 2, 5, 7, 3, 6, 4. If we add 10 to each entry, what will happen? 12, 15, then 17, and so on. Okay, then this is what the column C2. Okay, this is displaying the second column of the matrix A, and what is second column? 5, 6. Here we have done that thing. Next is, if you want to display some row of the given matrix, suppose the initial row, then it is A of 0 colon. Okay, this is what the first row. Then elementary operations can also be done in matrix with the matrices. How, before that, how to display the submatrix of a matrix? Suppose we have the matrix of order 3 by 3 and we want its submatrix. To find the submatrix, we need to give the range of the column and rows. Okay, suppose we want this block, the first submatrix including the first two entries of first row and first two columns. The submatrix including first two rows and first two columns only, that is what the square matrix. What we give the input? A of 0 comma 2, because see what is the output, then you got it. 1 0 1 2 is the first submatrix obtained by using this command. How to give the range of this rows and column? Because index starts from 0, if you give the range for the number of rows from 0 to 2, then it consider 0 to 1 only. It displays two rows, okay? And the range given for column is 0 to 2. It will again take the two columns only, from starting from 0 and 1. Because index starts from 0, it is considering the two columns, first column and second column. Hence, we are getting this submatrix. If we want submatrix as a 2, 1, 2 and 3. If we want submatrix of this matrix as 2, 1, 2, 3. See how to obtain that matrix. What we do? A in square bracket. What is the range for column? Range for row? We want second row and third row. 1, 2, 2, comma. Then range for column is same, 1, 2, 2. What is the output? See, it is only the single block matrix. If we change this from 0 to 2 and 0 to 2, what we get? 1, 0, 1, 2. Suppose I want to write this submatrix 2, 1, 2, 3. What should I do? Suppose we want to write this submatrix including second row, second column, second and third row, second and third column. 2, 1, 2, 3. This 2 by 2 is a submatrix of matrix A. If we want to display that matrix here, what we do? Are you getting me? Can anybody tell how to get another submatrix having entries 2, 1, 2, 3? Let us try it. Of course, it gives error. Okay, okay. 2, 1, 2, 3 is there. The range given for the rows is from 1 to 3. 1 stands for second row and 3 stands for next row, but 3 stands for 1 stands for second row and 3 stands for fourth row, but the 3 is not considered. It will stop at 2. We want second row and third row, and we want the intersection of second row, third row, second column and third column. That gives the submatrix 2, 1, 2, 3. Then if we give range of the rows from 1 to 3, it takes 2 rows only, starting from 1 and 2. Okay. And the range for the column is 1, 2, 3. It takes from 1 and ends at 2 only. This position for column is 1, 2. That means second column and third column. And the position for row is first, second. It is taking as first and second. That means second row and third row it is considering. From this, like this, we get the submatrix of the matrix A. Then Cayley-Hamilton theorem, we can find the eigenvalues of a square matrix by using the command np dot linear eigenvalues of A. Which are the eigenvalues? Because it is upper triangular, eigenvalues are 2, 3. See, they are in form of array. 2 and 3 are the two different eigenvalues. If we try to find eigenvectors, then it gives eigenvalue as well as eigenvectors. The first vector is in first column corresponding to first eigenvalue 2, 1, 0 is the eigenvector. For the eigenvalue 3, 0.9701 and 0.2425 is the second eigenvector. If we just try LA dot I of A, the same answer is here. Either you use linear command or LA command for to find the eigenvalues or eigenvectors. Now, to verify the Cayley-Hamilton theorem, we require characteristic polynomial. But to find the polynomial, we have to make some program. But here only we are checking whether A satisfying its characteristic polynomial or not. Then what we do? What is a characteristic polynomial actually for 2 by 2 matrix? It is for the matrix A, the characteristic polynomial is for x square. Suppose the variable is x, it is x square minus trace A plus determinant of A. Okay. And if we want to verify that Cayley-Hamilton theorem, we use instead of x as a A. Verify whether if C of X is the characteristic polynomial, then we check whether C of A is zero matrix or not. For that, we require the characteristic equation. For that, we find here trace of the matrix P is NP dot trace A. This is the A matrix 2, 4, 0, 3. Its trace is T. Suppose we are denoting it by T. Determinant is D. E is the identity matrix of order 2 by 2. Consider the left side of the characteristic polynomial. If we use the variable as a matrix, a square minus trace a into a plus determinant a into identity matrix of order 2 by 2. It is denoted by p. What should be p matrix? P should be zero matrix, because Kelly-Hamilton theorem states that every square matrix satisfies its characteristic polynomial. We have given all the entries, determinant, trace, and identity matrix of order 2 by 2 in this p. See what is the p expression? It is the zero matrix. Hence, we can verify the Kelly-Hamilton theorem for 2 by 2 matrix by using this short small number of commands. Suppose we have the 3 by 3 matrix. Before that, there is also one point of diagonalization of matrix. How to diagonalize matrix? We find first eigenvalues, then eigenvectors. We write eigenvectors in column wise in some matrix, say P, and that matrix should be invertible because all eigenvectors are linearly independent. And then we find P inverse into A into P. That matrix is diagonal matrix. If the matrix is diagonal, then we say A is diagonalizable matrix. And the diagonal matrix consists of diagonal entries as an eigenvalues of A matrix. Firstly, we require the matrix P. Already we have this eigenvectors 1, 0, 0, and second vector is 0.97, 0.24. Consider that vectors in single matrix P. Okay, this is the matrix P. We require P inverse also, because we are going to find P inverse AP. Suppose P inverse is Q. Q is the inverse of matrix P. Then how to obtain the diagonal matrix? It is Q means what? P inverse into A into P. But P inverse is denoted by Q here. Therefore, we are just finding Q into A into P. This is matrix multiplication, so at the rate symbol is used. What is D? This is the diagonal matrix having diagonal entries as an eigenvalues. See, the first entry is 2. First entry belongs to first row and first column is 2. That is the first eigenvalue. And the entry belongs to second row and second column is 3. But this entry is not exactly equal to 0. It is nearly equal to 0 because it is 1.999 into e to the power minus 0.8. So this is nearly equal to 0. This is what the diagonal matrix means. We have the matrix P that diagonalizes the given matrix A. And after diagonalization, the diagonal matrix is this. If we have 3 by 3 matrix, then how to verify Kelly-Hamilton theorem? There are some more steps than 2 by 2 matrix, because the characteristic polynomial for 3 by 3 matrix takes some more time. The matrix, the characteristic polynomial for 3 by 3 matrix can be calculated by using this way, or you can use your own way. Minus lambda cube plus trace a into lambda square plus 1/2 trace a square minus trace of a square into lambda plus determinant a. Here lambda is the variable. If we want to verify Kelly-Hamilton theorem, then we replace lambda by matrix a, and to the last constant we multiply identity matrix of order 3 by 3. What we do, if we have the 3 by 3 matrix, then we should find its trace. Suppose it is small t, its command is np dot trace a. Then we find a square, because we want trace of a square, or we directly find the trace of a square. See, np dot trace of a into a is nothing but trace a square. It is denoted by t1. Then in the last term, is which is constant term in this polynomial, is what? Determinant a. Determinant is suppose denoted by d. And the identity matrix of order 3 by 3 is e. E is np dot EYE of 3, that is what the identity matrix. Now replace A, lambda by A, everywhere in this characteristic polynomial, and see whether it gives answer as a zero matrix of order 3 by 3 or not. This is what the characteristic equation, its right side is 0. If we multiply this equation by minus sign, then it's also okay. after multiplying negative sign, what we get? Lambda cube minus trace a square minus 1 upon 2 and trace a whole square minus trace of a square into lambda minus determinant a. Here we have written the same thing, only we are verifying the Cayley-Hamilton theorem, hence lambda is replaced by a. Lambda is replaced by a, the first term is a cube. Here a into a into a is the product of a three times, that gives a cube, minus trace is denoted here by small t, into lambda square. We are replacing lambda by a. So here a into a, multiplication of two matrices. The next sign is plus. Okay, we want to change this sign, right? This should be minus. The first entry is, we have multiplied this equation by minus sign. The first a cube e product is with positive sign. Then second is negative. Third one is, it should be negative. Minus 0.5 is 1 by 2 value into trace a whole square. That means t into t. Trace a is t and trace of a square is t1. Minus t1 into a, the whole term into a, minus determinant into the identity matrix of order 3 by 3. See what is the answer? No, this sign should be plus. Okay, here is some mistake. This sign should be minus, okay? This gives the verification of Cayley-Hamilton theorem for 3 by 3 matrix. As we have diagonalized 2 by 2 matrix, by same way, we can diagonalize this 3 by 3 matrix. Now the system of linear equation, this, if we have three equations in three unknowns, then to solve the system of linear equation, this is a input for coefficient matrix, the right side constants, right side, the equations, sorry, this is the system of first order linear equation, and the linear equations has variables x, y, and z. We give the input A as a coefficient matrix of the three variables x, y, z. Its first row is 1, 1, 2, second row is 2, 4, minus 3, third row is 3, 6, minus 5. The right side constant matrix is 9, 1, 0, because it is column matrix, it is given in this way. Then how to solve this system, either by invertible method or by Gauss elimination method, we can solve. By invertible method, the system is solved here. A1 is inverse of the matrix A. How to get the solution of the system? It is in the form of AX is equal to B. So X, if we pre-multiply by A inverse to that equation, then we get X is equal to A inverse into B. A inverse is A1 here. And to make the matrix multiplication, we have used, this is what the multiplication of 3 by 3 matrix to the column vector. So dot is used, A1 dot, dot B. B is the column vector, A1 is 3 by 3 vector. The multiplication is given by this command. What is the answer? 1, 2, 3. The value of X is 1, Y is 2, and Z is 3. Similarly, and the same system is solved by using the another command. LA, in linear algebra, we are solving the system by using this command, LA dot solve A comma B. It gives the same output, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Is there any doubt? If we have the two equations in three unknowns, and it is the non-homogeneous system, then we generally use the least square method. How to use that method? We give the input of coefficient of unknown variable in the one matrix, that is suppose A, the right side column matrix is B, and we use to find the answer by using least square method, we use this command, LA dot LSTSQ, A is the coefficient matrix, B is right side constant matrix, R condition is equal to none. This by least square method, we get the answer of this system. It reduces the inconsistency of system. So for every system, we get the answer. Can anybody have a question? Okay, we stop here. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes.
Any question? All the participant. So okay, thank you, ma'am, for such a nice lecture, and thank you all the participant for attending this session.